Hey everyone, thanks for tuning in to this video. My name's Sean Taylor. I'm a recording engineer. Been at it for 15 or so years. Recently, I've been looking around to get a new monitor controller. I've just come to a point in my life where I need to take that next step forward towards sound quality for my studio. The one that seemed to call to me was this new piece from Slate. It's called Slate Control, and it's the analog central station, if you will, to their very famous Raven consoles. I remember seeing this at AES 2014. It instantly caught my eye, but I didn't have any time to check it out. And so I've waited patiently, and I've seen now that it's come out on the market, and I've been able to obtain one. So I thought it'd be cool to, I don't know, just go through some of the features, and then I could show you maybe a picture of the inside and the guts and what kind of circuitry is going on. And yeah, just give an overall rundown of the feature set, and then I'll kind of share some information about how I use it in my studio and some of the features I like the best. Slate Control ships in two pieces: the remote control, which you see here, and the base station. The base station is a two rack space unit that contains the majority of the electronics and all the I/O for hooking up your speakers, headphone outputs, etc. We connect the two together with a DB50 cable. Slate includes a 25-foot version, but you can request a 50-foot one if you'd like. Okay, one of the first things I'd like to go through are the monitor input selections, and those are done using these buttons right here. We can choose from Mix 1, Mix 2, QAB, QCD, External Input 1, External Input 2, and 1/8 inch. I think the 1/8 inch input is really cool, because it allows us to conveniently interface laptops and cell phones in the studio environment really easily. It has a built-in talkback microphone that activates when you hold the button down. And when you do that, it dims the studio monitors. You can set the level for the talkback adjusting this little calibration screw right here. It also has a left mute and a right mute, and that will mute the left and right signal. There's a mono button that will sum together the left and the right. You could reverse the polarity of the left speaker. That's really handy when you want to combine the signals together in mono to measure stereo width or to check to see what elements have phase issues. And finally, at the end, there's this calibration switch, and this is really cool. It lets us fix the volume of the studio monitors at a certain level. And when we engage the calibration button, the unit automatically raises or lowers the volume to the predetermined volume you've set using the little screw right here to the right. The giant knob right here controls the master volume of the speakers, and right next to that there's three different speaker selections, A, B, and C. Above each one of those you could engage a subwoofer, and you can plug the subwoofer into the back of the bass unit. There's an XLR output right there. And there's also some low frequency control, so you can roll off which frequencies are going to the subwoofer. Right here we have the volume controls for speaker set B and speaker set C. What's really cool about that is we can set the level of speaker A and then use these two pots to control the other levels in reference to speaker A. So we could level match all of our different loudspeakers to a consistent level. Over on this side of the remote, there's a bank of presets that allow us to choose where the talkback is going. If we engage this button, it sends the talkback out QAB. When we engage that button, it sends the talkback out QCD. QAB and QCD are a stereo pair of outputs on the back of the bass unit that are intended to drive headphone amps. This way here, you could have two separate headphone mixes for the artists. When I press this button, the talkback is sent to the local headphone outputs right here. When I press the Slate button, it sends the talkback to a pair of outputs labeled Mix 1 and Mix 2 on the back of the bass unit. Those outputs' signal is derived from the input Mix 1 and the input Mix 2 on the back of the bass unit. There's a few more features that are pretty cool. One of them is the ability to use an external talkback mic. And when you engage that button, you set the level for the external right here. There is an XLR input on the back of the bass unit that you can plug your external mic into. On many large format consoles, there's a function called a reverse talkback mic, and Slate thought that would be a good idea to put on this controller, and you engage that by pressing this button here. When the button is engaged, it allows the artist in the recording studio to talk directly to the control room, and we could set the level for that microphone using this knob right here. There is also a microphone input jack on the back of the bass unit that you plug in the reverse talkback mic into. Check out this feature in the top right corner. It's called a auto talkback mic. Basically, here's how it works. You output a tone on a pair of tracks from your DAW into the input on the back of the bass unit. It senses the level coming from the computer, and when there's no music, it engages the talkback circuit. This is a really cool feature because it allows us to communicate with the artist between takes without having to press the talkback button every single time we want to communicate. Finally, on the right side, we have this button called Control Room to QAB. This is a cool feature because it allows us to take whatever is selected in our control room input and send it out QAB stereo output on the back of the bass unit. At the top of the remote control, we have two knobs. The knob on the left controls what these two headphone outputs are listening to. We can monitor what's on the control room input select. We can also monitor what's coming in on mix 2. We can monitor what's coming in on QAB and QCD. We can listen to any of the external inputs, 1 and 2, and we can even listen to the 1/8 inch input. Just to the right, there's another knob labeled QCD input selection. And we use that knob to select which input source is going to QCD outputs. There are 7 options we can choose from. We can have it in the off position, or we can monitor what our control room is selecting. We could listen to what our local headphones are listening to. We also could take the inputs for QCD from the back of the bass unit and send those down outputs QCD. We can monitor external 1, external 2, and we can even monitor the 1/8 inch input. We use this knob right here to set the level for that output. And when I engage this button here, it takes the signal I've selected on QCD and sends it down to a pair of outputs on the back of the base station. This is a great feature for recording studios that have loudspeakers on the studio floor and wish to play content out of those loudspeakers from the control room. Finally, in the top left corner, we have 2 USB ports. These are really handy for charging your cell phone, plugging in a thumb drive, or connecting an iLock. Everyone's studio setup is slightly different, so how each person ends up using and interfacing with Slate Control is going to be different from one another. I primarily use Mix 1 and Mix 2 to monitor the output of my summing amp. This is really cool because it allows me to compare 2 different stereo bus chains. For instance, on Mix 1, I can have a Pultec style EQ with SSL compression, and on Mix 2, I could have a totally different compressor and a totally different EQ, and compare the two to determine which one I like better. For my studio setup, I use QAB and QCD to drive a pair of headphone amplifiers. I primarily use external 1 and external 2 to bring in sound sources from my laptop or cell phone. It's really handy when you want to compare your mix against reference material from Spotify and iTunes. Same thing goes for the 1/8 inch input. In our studio, we have 2 pairs of studio monitors, a pair of near fields, and a pair of small mid-range Auratone speakers. So being able to switch between the two of them easily is definitely a handy feature. All in all, I feel the build quality is done extremely well with this device. All the knobs feel very firm. They feel very nice when I turn them. All the switches feel like they're well made and will last for thousands and thousands of button presses. The illumination is very bright and clear, so you'll be able to see which buttons are engaged and should have no problems hitting the correct button when you go to make a selection. Some people have brought up the fact that there is no digital to analog conversion on board Slate Control, but I don't find that to be a problem. Mainly because I have my own digital to analog converter, and I think that the majority of us out there like to choose our own for various reasons. So Slate not including one as part of the package actually creates more flexibility than if they were to choose a digital to analog converter for us. I love the flexibility and the routing of the talkback system. There aren't many controllers on the market that can route the headphone system quite like Slate Control can. I found the sound quality to be absolutely enjoyable. What I've noticed with my mixes is that the detail is more present. I can hear more reverb tails. I can isolate frequencies better. The lows sound much tighter and the highs sound much brighter. Things pop out that used to be cloudy and veiled. And I know sometimes that's very cliche language in the audio industry, but in this case it really is true. Compared to my old PreSonus monitor controller, this is a major upgrade, and I can't wait to start making music using Slate Control as the centerpiece to my studio. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Thank you for tuning in, and hey, who knows, maybe in the future I might make another one. If you have any questions or comments, please just leave them in the comment section below. Otherwise, we'll see you next time.